I got this Vevor mini lathe here, and I wanted to cut a metric thread with a 1.5 millimeter pitch. And the table on here shows what gears I need to place on the posts here so that when the spindle turns, it turns the lead screw at the right rate to get that pitch. I need an 84 and a 60 and a 40 and a 52, but looking at the gears I've got, no 84 tooth gear. So I thought, oh rats, they forgot to send the 84 tooth gear. So I'll just have to work out a different combination to get that 1.5 millimeter pitch. And I didn't want to just place gears on here by trial and error, because that'd be way too tedious. So I made my own spreadsheet to work out the pitches, and conveniently, I could just check it against here to make sure that my math was correct. Except a whole lot of the numbers just didn't match up, and inconsistently so. So I had to check the formulas in my spreadsheet again and again. I even did the calculations by hand, and it just kept coming out that my spreadsheet did not agree with the threading table. But my spreadsheet did agree with some of the values, like this pitch and this pitch, although for the imperial pitches, not one of them agreed. So not only does this threading table refer to gears that the lathe doesn't come with, it's also just plain wrong. The spreadsheet makes it much easier to try different combinations than on the lathe itself, so this one is off by 15%, for example. So if I put 66 tooth on here for the first one, then I'm off by only 2.9%, which is still not great. So I just need a way of trying all possible combinations and see what works best, and that's what computers are for. And so I wrote a Python program to work out all these combinations. And if I run that program, it works out 2,385 different combinations, but a lot of those are duplicates, so just 467 unique ratios, and it prints out the list of those, and also where some of my target pitches are, so I can figure out what's closest to those. But I can change that script to only print out the numbers that are close to the targets. So this shows the target and the numbers on either side of it, so this one I could hit exactly. 0.7 millimeters, I could only approximate to an error of 0.286%. 0.8 millimeters, also approximating. 1 millimeter, hit exactly, etc. So a much better threading table than that came with a lathe. And I can also configure it to use imperial threads. And it gets pretty close on most of the imperial pitches, although it's not able to hit any of those bang on. Because an inch is 2.54 centimeters, so to go from metric to inches, you need a gear ratio of 50 to 127. And that's the smallest fraction that you can reduce it to. But that's only if you want it exact. You can get really, really close without 127 tooth gear. And importing these values into my spreadsheet, for the metric ones, I can get all of them within a fraction of a percent. For the imperial ones, it's not as good. The worst one would be the 16 TPI at 0.89% off. So let's try that 16 TPI gear combination, which is the worst one. And the one in here means I can just put any gear in this position. Before cutting a real thread, I just thought I'd do a sanity check with an existing 3/8 inch thread which got 16 TPI. So I've got my cutter in a groove of one of these things, and let's start that lathe. So let's hand crank that a few turns. And it stays lined up pretty good across quite a few turns. So let's try cutting an actual screw thread. So for a regular 3/8 inch nut, this thread works just fine. But let's try a coupler nut, which has got a much deeper thread. Oh, all the way on. So that thread is really quite close enough for a 3/8 inch thread, even though it's 1% off. But if I hold this 3/8 inch bolt up against it, you can see it's close, but the alignment from one side to the other varies a little bit because that pitch is off by almost a percent. So that pitch error matters less than I thought it would, but I'm not done, because I agreed to make a new threading table for Vevor for a small fee. And unlike the old threading table, I want to make sure these are all good, which means I have to try placing all these gears on there, because not all gear combinations work. If the gears are too big, then this post will have to move too far beyond the end of this bar, and if all the gears are too small, then the top gear won't reach this here, My script checks for gears hitting each other and overall too big and too small, but actually placing the gears is a much better check.
Here's 10 TPI. I didn't bother locking all these down with bolts. I just want to make sure it fits, and it just barely fits inside the case. And my third one for 12 TPI didn't fit, but I can rearrange these. For instance, I can swap this gear and this gear without changing the ratio, and now I made it fit. 18 TPI sticks out a little bit here, so it won't fit inside the case, and I can't rearrange it to fit. So I found another solution, which is slightly less accurate, but at least I can close it. And the metric combination that I can't get to fit in here, so I'll have to go with a slightly less accurate one to make that fit.
And the next less accurate one didn't fit either, and neither did the one after that, so I ended up going with one that's a full percent off, so worst one, but I know that's still workable. Now I could get my gear ratios even closer to target if I could have any size gear I wanted to, but I'm not sure about making gears like this, but I can make wooden gears.
So if I just had a gear pair that was a 5 to 6 gear ratio, I could make my 16 TPI gear entry here to within 0.06%. So I've been using my gear generator program, which I sell on my website by the way, to design a gear pair, except 5 and 6 I use 18 and 15 so the teeth aren't so coarse. And I have to be very careful that the overall diameter of this gear is less than 50 millimeters, so that works out there. And then I printed that out. And that is exactly the same size it is on the screen because I told the program that the screen width here is 16 centimeters and entered that here, which basically makes this display exactly 1:1 on the screen. But then I had the idea of looking in my gears drawer, and there's actually quite a few gears that have the same pitch that could be adapted to the lathe. And among those gears, I found those two, which were very easy to adapt. I just had to mill that out in the middle a little bit. And these are different tooth counts from what I've got already. And if I add that 49 and 44 tooth gear to the gears my program has to choose from, I now have 912 unique gear ratios, whereas before I only had 435. And the average pitch error is also much less. And I graphed my average pitch error. Blue is without the extra gears, and purple is with, and the average error went from 0.3% to 0.093. But I could do even better because I could buy this gear set from Vevor. Now that duplicates a lot of gears I already have, but it also has a lot of gears that I don't have. And with that larger set of gears, plus the gears I already have with the lathe, the program now takes a bit longer to run. And we now have 3,843 unique gear ratios, whereas before we had 435, and the pitch errors are even less. And I added those to my bar graph in yellow, and the errors are much smaller, in fact, just 0.022% now.
So if you have enough gears, you can hit pretty much any thread pitch arbitrarily close. It just takes a little bit of programming to figure out what gears to use for what.